Now here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. Minneapolis Federal Reserve President Neel Kashkari says the prediction that the U.S. central bank will cut interest rates once this year is reasonable. Kashkari says they are taking their time to get more data on inflation, economy, and the labor market. But should there be a cut, he says it would likely be toward the end of the year. The Fed last week held its benchmark policy rate steady to keep continued pressure on the economy so as to cool inflation. On to more news. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky fails to win over several key nations from the global south to support his bid against Russian invasion. A two-day summit in Switzerland aimed at ending the war in Ukraine wraps up with key powers rejecting a joint communique. India, Saudi Arabia, South Africa, and the United Arab Emirates all attended the summit but did not sign the agreement, which is a commitment to refrain from using force to threaten the territorial integrity or political independence of any state. In other news, Bill Gates preparing to put billions of dollars into a next-generation nuclear power plant project in the American state of Wyoming. Terra Power, a startup founded by Gates, broke ground for the construction of its first commercial reactor in the state, where coal plant is shutting down. Terra Power's plant, which is backed by the U.S. Energy Department, was initially expected to be operational in 2028. But Gates says that would have meant relying on fuel from Russia, which he says is unacceptable now. Meanwhile, Saudi Arabia's mining minister will reportedly travel to Chile next month in a bid to source lithium. The visit comes as Saudi Arabia mulls entering the electric vehicle sector. Chile is the world's second largest producer of lithium, a key material for making the batteries that power EVs. Moving on, beaches on Singapore's Sentosa Island closed since Saturday following an oil spill spread from a nearby shipping terminal. The oil had spread from Pasir Panjang Terminal, less than 10 kilometers from the tourist hotspot, after a Netherlands-flagged dredger struck a stationary Singapore-flagged bunker vessel on Friday. Now on to some tech news. OpenAI mulling changing its governance structure to a for-profit business. This means removing the nonprofit board's control of the firm. Same with rivals Anthropic and xAI. A for-profit organization operates with a goal of making money. And finally, Tesla is set to use the strong support for Elon Musk's $56 billion pay package to try to win over a Delaware judge that invalidated his 2018 agreement. The automaker's shareholders approved the pay package on Thursday, which is aggressive targets for Tesla's financial performance and market value. But Delaware Judge Kathleen McCormick in January called the package an unfathomable sum granted by a conflicted board with close personal and financial ties to CEO Musk. Now, plastic debris take on a new life to spread awareness about ocean pollution. Toothbrushes, bottle caps, and beach toys. These are just a few examples of the rubbish that now make up larger-than-life sculptures currently on display at the New York Aquarium. The exhibit, Washed Ashore, Art to Save the Sea, consists of 35 sea life sculptures made entirely from marine debris collected from beaches. Its goal is to educate the public about the growing problem and inspire positive change in consumer habits.
Plastics in the ocean can be a source of multiple problems for animals. Sometimes they don't realize that they are plastic and they'll eat them instead. And one that's really well known is sea turtles that feed on jellyfish will mistake plastic bags for jellyfish. And that's why reducing our use of plastic bags, those single-use plastic bags, is so important.
Washed Away, the nonprofit behind the exhibit, has collected more than 60,000 pounds of debris since its founding in 2010. Its plastic animals have been displayed across the U.S. and Canada, with one sculpture finding a permanent home at the Smithsonian's National History Museum.